If you edit music videos, you know that making the cut look good before applying any effects is one of the most important parts of the actual process. In today's video, I'm going to be breaking down an easier way to cut your music videos without having to watch each video one by one throughout your timeline. We're going to be doing this by using a tool called Multicam in Premiere Pro. By using this method, we're able to watch every single take of this music video at one time while making the cut. That way, it's kind of like a live comparison view of all the videos that you took for this music video or for whatever music video that you're working on. It's a great way to ensure that the best clips are picked for your music video while making the cut, and it also helps speed up the editing process tenfold. I do want to mention that if you have a video that you might want edited by me and maybe featured on this channel, make sure to reach out to me on Instagram. I'm currently accepting new projects, and I'd be very stoked to hear from you guys and help you out on your next edit. And who knows, I might even end up using your video on my channel in a tutorial and giving you some free promo as well. If you're excited to learn about multicam editing in Premiere Pro, make sure to hit the like button down below and let's dive in. All right guys, so here in Premiere Pro on my timeline, we have a music video by an artist named Ace Star. We've done a couple edits together. I believe he's from the UK. He's a really dope rapper. And the song we're editing today is called Delayed Gratification. It's a minute and a half long, so it's a pretty short music video. And we have four takes here that they filmed inside the recording studio of him just performing the entire song. First thing we need to do is stack our videos on separate layers. So take this first clip, for example. Let's just move the audio down to audio layer 2. For this next one, let's stack it so it's like this. And you can see kind of what I'm doing here. I'm just stacking each clip and audio on separate layers. Now what we can do is highlight everything, including the audio file for the song, right click and select synchronize. We're going to make sure that it's syncing to the actual song file here in the beginning and hit okay. This is going to sync up all of our audio so that we don't have to manually sync the audio for each take. What I'm going to do from here is right click and select unlink, and we can just delete the audio from all of our video clips. So we're just left with the audio from the song file. And now if I hit play, it should be perfectly synced with his lips in every shot. So let's check it out.
Be by the front step, trying to focus on my passion. All I know is serving addicts, still got work up in the attic, send the text and watch it vanish.
So you can see right there, it's perfectly synced. Now what I'm gonna do is just cut the excess off the beginning of this video here. And then we're just gonna slide all of our layers to the very beginning just to stay nice, neat, and organized. Let's make sure all of our layers are turned on here and fully visible. And I will say, pro tip for those of you filming music videos, it's important that you have a good speaker playing in the background of your video. That way you can easily sync the audio from your video clips to the audio of the actual song file when it comes to editing. If you're filming a music video and the artist is playing the song off of an iPhone or something that's really hard to hear, the Premiere Pro sync feature is going to be a lot harder to use. It might not be able to synchronize your videos to the audio layer on your timeline. So you want to make sure that you can clearly hear the song being played in the background of the actual video clips. That way this synchronization process works flawlessly. So now that I have all my video layers stacked here on my timeline, I'm just going to highlight all my video clips, right click and select nest. This is going to basically flatten all of our video clips into one layer here. Now I'm going to right click on this new layer and I'm going to select multi-camera enable. The next thing you have to do is click on this wrench button for settings and select multi-camera. And now you'll see all of our video clips showing up here on the left while our video composite shows up here on the right. Cutting with multicam is pretty simple at this point. So you're basically going to use the numbers on your keyboard to pick which shot you want. So this is shot 1. Then if I hit 2, it's going to switch to shot 2. 3 and 4 right here. And as I play this back, I can click on each one of these numbers to switch the scene, and it's going to automatically make the cuts here on my timeline. So let's just start at the beginning, and I'm just going to hit 1 or 2 right here in the beginning to pick one of these shots. And when I'm picking a shot and when the cut is actually happening, this yellow box is going to turn red. So you'll see what I mean here in a second. Let's go ahead and hit play, and I'm just going to hit 1 to kind of start off our timeline here. So you'll see what I mean. Just watch this yellow box. Then we can switch to 3. Let's go to 4. back to one. So right there, if I pause it, you can see our timeline now has made cuts for each of those video clips that we wanted. And you can see if I zoom in here, it has the specific clip that's being shown listed on our timeline. So right there, we basically just made kind of the intro cut. Let's go ahead and just work our way through the rest of this timeline.
I've been dreaming of a new life, waking up to blue skies, ocean with the sunset, clientele say I ain't done yet, phones stay ringing, flood the strip until there's none left, switching up the spots, I tell them meet me by the front step, trying to focus on my passion, all I know is serving addicts, still got work up in the attic, send a text and watch it vanish, turn my manuscripts to ballads, like a poet when I'm rapping, putting in this work to see my family living lavish, used to post up by the one stop, had it buzzing like a conch box, couldn't find the time to eat, I had to carry around a lunchbox, coming short, I risked my freedom, better make that shit a one off, delay gratification. Staying down until I come up, we go grind until the sun up. Work while they sleep, never let them get the one up. They'd rather see me starve, but I stay eating, ain't no hunger. Really came from nothing. When you lose it all, it's gonna prove you really love you for real.
Delayed gratification means to sacrifice the hedonism of the present to the security and iterability of the future. And so that is a hallmark of maturity. That's also the ability to.
So there at the end, you can see now we have our entire timeline cut here and it's looking pretty good. I felt really good about how I just cut that using the numbers in the timeline. Now it's really easy then to hop back here into our timeline and just adjust the clips as needed. Maybe I missed a cut or maybe I let one of these clips go on for too long. I can just zoom in here and just adjust the cuts on my timeline. So it's super simple, super easy way to cut your video. And then to get out of Multicam, I'm just gonna click on this wrench and click on composite video. And now we're back to our main kind of default look here in the timeline. My hope is that this tutorial helps some of you guys speed up your editing workflow and create better music videos by using the Multicam feature in Premiere Pro. If you have any questions about Multicam editing or run into any problems while using the Multicam feature in Premiere Pro, make sure to comment down below or reach out to me on Instagram and I'd be happy to help you. And if you're a video creator who's looking to add some extra sauce to your next edit, make sure to go check out ventervisuals.com. I have a bunch of video templates, editing packs, and more on there, which you can use on your next video, including a free pack, has a few overlays, transition presets, title templates, and more. So if that sounds interesting to you, make sure to check the links in the description down below this video. If you have any video ideas for what you'd like to see me create on this channel, make sure to comment them down below. Absolutely love hearing from you guys, and I've gotten so many good ideas from people who comment on my videos. So please do if you have any creative, unique ideas. I appreciate everybody for tuning in on another great tutorial. Until next time, I'm Jake Venner. Peace out.